Can y'all say praise the Lord one time?
Praise the Lord one time.
Yes, isn't it good to be in the house of the Lord today?
Yes.
Wow, we ain't even getting started yet.
Yeah.
Wow.
Praise the Lord.
I tell you what, let's do another good old song of the church. Well, I was standing by my window.
I don't hear any horns sounding out there.
You will.
Okay, there they are, okay. Want to thank everyone for being with us today on Pritchett Chapel. We have three forms of media today. We have FM 88.5, if you can hear us on the radio. We have Facebook, if you want to watch us on Facebook. And what's the other form? Oh, we're here. A little slow there, a little slow. I got a touch from God a while ago, and wow. Isn't it great to get a touch from God?
Yes.
I respect those that serve God and never have felt His presence. I respect it. Don't quite grasp it, because He wants to touch you. If you've never touched Him, wow, you get an opportunity for Him to touch you and you to be with Him. I personally, for Steve, there's nothing better. But we're going to get started. I've been listening to some of the music since about 9:30. And just for a little bit, I'd say no sermon, just let them preach. Let them preach through music. I don't need that. But join me by grabbing your Bibles or touching the TV or touching your radio. And join me by saying, I believe that I am.
I believe that I am.
What my Bible says that I am.
What my Bible says that I am.
Now, if my Bible says it.
If my Bible says
it. I have a right to say it.
I have a right to say it.
My Bible says.
My Bible says.
That I'm more than a conqueror.
I'm more than a conqueror.
That makes me want to shout.
That makes me want to shout.
Here we go now.
Hallelujah.
My mind's alert.
My mind's alert.
My heart is open.
My heart is open.
And we're going to.
Praise the Lord.
Brother Barry.
We're going to have Brother James start it off. James, tell him something out there.
Well, you know, I'm satisfied where I'm at in my life right now.
You know what, James? You've come a long way, Hoss.
Oh, I know. I know. If you'd have thought I'd be here 2 years ago, you were probably right. I wouldn't be here. You know
what I mean?
You're
a walking miracle.
I believe I am, too. Amen. Got two sisters, I think, that are also. Amen. But this is why. I've got that old time religion. I got that old time religion, and that is why I'm satisfied. When you ask if I'm happy, if I have journeys in, I'm satisfied with my Jesus, and when He knocks, I'm going to let Him in, and He'll go with me.
Songs. I love this song right here. Jason, hit us up on that. Tell us about writing this song.
Well, I got to thinking about all the old songs and how everyone just keeps writing these new songs. And you've got songs that are like Caleb, where they sing these new style songs. And then you've got your old churches, like your old Baptist churches, that sing out the hymnals. You know, there's nothing wrong with a new song. But there's nothing wrong with the old songs.
Right.
You know, there's still anointing in those old songs. There ain't nothing wrong with them. We grew up on them. They were good enough for our grandparents. They were good enough for our parents. They're good enough for me, and they're good enough for my kids.
Come on.
So there ain't nothing wrong with the old songs. So this is a new song about the old songs. They call me a dreamer, get a real job, they say, 'cause that music you're singing, it's not for today. Oh, but I beg to differ, I've got the songs of yesterday. We need songs like the lighthouse and like Amazing Grace, the sweet rock of ages, and I'll fly away. Yeah.
Praise the Lord. And hey, you know what? Let's do a couple of them old songs, Lord. You do a good old song they've been singing for a while. Let's do the Walk Them Golden Stairs. Y'all ready? Key of C, I think.
All right, here we go. One, two, three, four.
Group back in Eastern Kentucky, and they used to do this song right here. It's called Canaan's Land is Just Inside. It goes
That's
like
right.
this.
One, two, three, four.
Moses led God's children 40 years. He led them through the storm and through the night. Where we're going. song right there now.
Hey, Potter, would you do me a favor?
Yes.
I would like for you to sing that one more time, but do it a cappella and real slow like they did in the old days.
All right, let's try it. Let's see if I can do it. Y'all ready? Moses led God's children 40 years. He led them through the storm and through the night. Though they said, let's turn back, Moses said, keep going. Canaan land is just inside. There will be no sorrow there in that tomorrow. We will be there by and by. Milk and honey flowing, that is where we're going. Canaan land is just inside. Canaan land is just inside. Woo, good one there, Jason. Man, I felt that. I hope y'all felt that like I felt that.
I like it.
You know what? We're going to walk through the coronavirus thing here, right?
Yep.
I'm almost over it myself. I'm done with it.
Yeah.
We're going to walk through it. We're going to walk to heaven, right?
Right.
Nothing going to stop us. Just keep on trudging like Moses did when they came out of there. That's good. Thank you, Jason, for that, man. God touched me on that. I appreciate that. Well, let's see here. We got Bobby always does a fantastic job and has got a Bob, you kind of got a praise report to tell us about there, don't you, sir?
I had a scan last week. You know what they saw?
What'd they see?
Nothing.
Woo!
Praise the Lord!
Nothing.
I like that better than I do stable, Bobby. It's a better word.
Well, this is the church that believes in a cancer-killing God.
Amen.
I should have heard a bunch of amens on that one.
Amen.
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 Take that, devil.
a good question. If Jesus comes tomorrow and you're not ready, what then?
Hades.
Yeah, that's right. Hammer down said Hades. That's right. All right, let's do, oh, okay, yeah, come on up.
Okay, I'm going to give you a second. Those of you that are watching on Facebook, if you have a prayer request, just kind of type it in your prayer request, and I'm going to tell you a few prayer requests and a couple announcements, and then we're going to go back to singing and praising God, and I know that you are blessed. In addition to the one camera with a little bitty microphone that you see me on FaceTime, there are four other cameras that are putting together a high class with sound effect, with the soundboard and hammer down, taking care of that. It is a much better quality than just one little camera. So you can go back in tomorrow afternoon and look at this whole program with a more professional shot. I just want y'all to be aware of that. And tell your friends about it. It's your opportunity to witness to God, and you don't witness to God by just simply pushing a button. Bad form. Bad form. So don't be afraid to push a button saying, hey, this may be something you're interested in. Those that are saved and those that aren't saved, so that they can be. Just receive word that one of our dear ladies in the church, Sister Patty Nyswanger, is suffering from her UTI. And we want God to touch her and minister to her. Continue to remember Sister Judy Stanley, Sister Sue Alexander. Continue to remember Bobby. That was a great testimony. And Jim Davis, and is there any more? You got anything coming up there, JoJo?
Mickey and Christina.
Mickey and Christina. And from now on Sunday, when we do this, and there's prayer requests, send it to us so we can pray.
Yeah.
So at this time,
can I add my mama?
Add
she
mama.
She actually called about 10:30 and said, pray for her hip. It's really been bothering her. And she mentioned James. She wanted to make sure everybody prayed for her.
Everybody.
She loves James. Tell James to pray for me.
Who don't?
I said, Brother Ron told me before church started, his mom could use a touch from God. I know my mom could use a touch from God.
Amen. I've got an unspoken request.
We got an unspoken request. And I know Alan's not been feeling 100%. This whole group up here is the miracles. So we want God. You need to continue to remember in prayer this entire team. What we got, JoJo? Sister Perkins is just came out of surgery, I think, last week. We're going to continue to remember her.
She goes back to work soon.
She okay?
And Miss Peggy said to pray for Steve. He has bad bruised ribs from surgery.
Okay. We want to pray for Steve. He just came out of surgery, I think, last week as well. So we want to ask God to remember them. So would you join with me?
Hey, remember all our church.
Yes.
Amen.
Yeah.
The whole, not just the platform. I agree. The whole church. I think April, somebody posted that, you know, when this first started, the church is kind of united and we were excited. There is starting to be division amongst churches all over America. And somebody wrote a beautiful article, don't let this destroy your church.
Right on. Yeah.
Don't let this destroy your church. Paul says, I'm unto all men, all things that I might win some. To the Greeks, I'm a Greek. To the Romans, I'm a Romans. To the Jews, I'm to the Jews. And he said, I'm not going to let anything I do offend somebody. Now listen to me. He said, if I got a brother that's beside me, he said, I can eat anything. I can eat pork. I can eat roast. But if I got a brother that's beside me that thinks it's wrong, I won't do it because I won't offend my brother. See, we want it our way and only our way because our way is the right way. It's the only way that matters. I'm the only one that hears from God. Be careful. You may be challenged from hearing from God. If you want to be like a Christian, you submit yourself. I don't know where that came from, buddy. That is all over me there. Let's pray. Father, I thank you that you hear us when we pray. You're ever mindful, ever mindful. The word says that you emphatically want to hear us to talk to you. You've heard the petitions. The word says that you know what we need before we even ask it. But we are to ask it. And you've heard the petitions that need help. For our whole church, we pray, God, that you let us continue to be an example to you. Heal those, Lord, that need to be healed. The brokenhearted, God. those that are in desperate shape financially, those that don't know where to go socially. In the name of Jesus, speak peace from the Prince of Peace. In the remainder of the service, that we are touched and we magnify the only name that needs to be magnified, Jesus' name. We pray. Amen. We've been receiving many offerings from the P.O. Box 203. If you aren't coming and you want to send your tithes and offerings in P.O. Box 203, the great city of Hanson, Kentucky, 42413. 42413. We'll make sure every penny gets to the right thing. Those of you that come, there's a big trash can out there marked tithes and offerings. You can put your offerings in there. And if I think that's it, we're going to hit some music and I got a sermon.
All right.
So at this time, I give you back the world's greatest team of praise and worshipers, the Pritchett Chapel Praise and Worship Team.
Thank you, Pastor. Marlon, Flory's going to sing a good song right here. Talks about standing still and letting God move in His time, just like He said.
The Father has a plan, though it's hard to see now. You feel you're walking all alone, but He is there, no doubt. When the storm around you rages and you're tossed to and fro, when you're faced with life's decisions, not sure which way to go, stand still and let God.
Clarksville, Tennessee. Be with us every Sunday.
Such a good ride. This song I want to do, I'm going to tell you right now. I'm 5 years, the 15th of this month, I was clean and sober. And you don't know how proud I am of that, and I know I couldn't have done it without a Savior.
Amen.
And it's just... it's amazing, but I mean, you know, when God, when you ask God to help you, he certainly will.
Yeah.
And we're going to do this song entitled, I Serve a Savior, and it goes like this.
So when you hear love in this song right here, you can substitute God in there. So it's one that goes like this.
One, two, three, four.
Come on now. Steve Terry.
There'll be some out there that says that's a secular song. Please listen to me for a couple of minutes. If you don't even hear the sermon, listen to me for a couple of minutes. It is our responsibility as a Christian to portray Christ the very best we can. And without the love of Jesus Christ, where would I be? I'd be in hell. I'd be in hell. If you are so spiritually minded, you're no earthly good, God can't ever use you. You understand what I just said? If all you think of is negative, and you look at the time, say, or the code, you look at the thing, and all you can do is see things negative, you will never be able to win that loss that you can never win. Huh? My dad had a magnificent sermon called Mouse Under the Chair, and it dealt with a mouse that went to the Queen's coronation in England. And the poem says, pussycat, where hast thou been? Oh, I've been to London to see the Queen. Pussycat, what didst thou see? I saw the mouse under the Queen's chair. And all the glory and all the majesty and all the surroundings, the millions, if not hundreds of millions of dollars in jewelry and fine clothing, all the cat could see was that ugly mouse. And if your walk with God is always negative, and if your walk with God is always based on looking and being critical and being subject to bad things, you're no better than that cat that traveled 50 miles to see the Queen's coronation because you can't see the glory of God. I feel sorry for you. I should have heard an amen or a few cars out there honking horns. I got a few. Join with me as we go to the Word of God. I have been so touched today. Many times I get touched. Sometimes there's people around, I get touched. Sometimes there's people around, I don't get touched. I mean, I really think it's up to you if you want to get touched. If I'm allowed to go eat, whatever you say, whatever your finest restaurant is, let's say I go out to eat and Troy or Ron, and I'm not fasting. Don't miss it. James would say, Stevie, I want to take you out to eat. Let's go. Where's your favorite place? And we decided to go to Patty's. I kind of like Patty's too. It's a pork chop. And we sit there. And the waitress comes in her beautiful little 1980s attire. And she says, Mr. Terry, what do you want to eat? And I'll take the hamburger. Sir, I'm telling you, we got some of the finest 2-inch pork chops in the world. Just give me a plain hamburger. Sir, I can dress that hamburger up, make it medium, perfect, lettuce, tomato, cheese, just a plain hamburger. Would you like anything to drink? We have the greatest sweet tea. Water. See, that's the way some people rethink concerning Jesus Christ and the relationship with God. It's plain. No, there's nothing plain about being a Christian, one way or the other. I am on a tear today. I trust that it is inspired of God. I trust it's inspired of God. Father, for the next moments, that comes out of my mouth, somehow, O Lord, that comes out of my mouth is pleasing to thee and ministers to those. In Christ's name I pray. And you join me by saying amen. 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 Let me, John's Gospel. Let's go to the 10th chapter. I was telling Barry last week, I personally believe last week, God revealed something to me that I had never heard taught before, T-A-U-G-H-T, taught before. It could be specifically for me. Sometimes God gives you insight and it's for you. And then there's sometimes God gives you insight and it's for somebody else concerning the Holy Spirit. Now, if you call it the Holy Ghost, that's fine. Actually, if you study it, it's the same thing. The Holy Spirit and the Holy Ghost are unique. They're together. They're one. Okay? I knew a man that he got mad at the pastor because the pastor said Holy Spirit instead of saying the Holy Ghost. That's shallow. That's shallow. Grow up. Grow up. Grow up. And Christ is talking to his disciples, and I have this unique approach when I discuss Christ. They're either around a campfire Huh? Or they're walking. And he's talking to them as they're walking. John 10, verse 26. But ye believe not because ye are not my sheep, as I have said unto you. My sheep hear my voice, and I know them that follow me. And I give unto them eternal life, and they shall never perish, neither shall any man pluck them out of my hand. Today I want to talk to you about understand the language of the Holy Spirit. This is going to be a little series. My sheep know my voice. My sheep know my voice. Today we have many people that say God spoke to them. I'm kind of like Ray Stevens. Those of you that know Ray Stevens, he had this song, Would Jesus Wear a Rolex? Huh? One of my dear friends, David East, is over there. Barry Potter, he loves Ray Stevens. And I'm still one day, if somebody hears this thing, get me to Ray Stevens. Because Barry Potter wrote one of the greatest Ray Stevens songs, and Ray's never heard it. And I have promised by Barry that before Ray dies, that Ray's going to hear this song. It's Red Beans.
Soup
beans.
What?
Somebody repeat that for my hearing.
Soup beans.
Okay. Soup beans, cornbread, and a red Vidalia onion. And it will do Ray Stevens. But Ray Stevens wrote this song, Would Jesus Wear a Rolex? Okay. So I don't care about this. That's okay. The song's fine. It's funny. But in it has a very popular line that I think is perfect. In it, it says, I want to talk to God and ask him, does he really talk to all those people that say he's talking to them? Huh? Come on now. We got 6,000 years of word in the Bible. Now, does God talk to people? Undeniably. Undeniably. But I know a lot of people, they think God talks to them like they're talking to their wife. Understand this. Please carefully understand this. Is the President of the United States, whether you like him or you don't like him, I don't care. If he was wanting to talk to you personally, you wouldn't take it like it's just a routine thing. Huh? And yet we want to act like God's just, he's routine. He's the creator of the universe. He said, let there be light, and there was. Do not act like that's just a routine thing that God speaks. Oh, he's in me. Uh-huh. You better be very, very cautious when you say, thus saith the Lord. Because the word of God said every I better be dotted. Every comma should be in the right place. Everything should be perfect. Everything should be perfect. Be careful. And Jesus said, my sheep know my voice. Now, I got a question to ask you. Are we sheep or lamb? See, lamb, the shepherd's always got to bring the lamb back in, doesn't he? Why? Because the lamb doesn't know the voice of the shepherd. April's got this dog, and this dog, believe it or not, is listening to this program right now, this service. And this dog's name is Ariadne. Ariadne. Now, that's a hard name to say. And April like to race this dog against other dogs. It is a wiener dog, and they call that a wiener dog dachshund, I think. And it races against other wiener dogs, and the race before us, the announcer got the name wrong for the winner. The winner was Chanel number 5, and it kept calling it Channel number 5. Well, when it came to pronouncing this dog's name, it nailed Ariadne. It nailed, the announcer nailed the song, the name Ariadne. And he kept saying, there goes Ariadne, trained by April Terry. There goes Ariadne, is walking it, because he had nailed that name. Now, to this day, that dog struggles with the name Ariadne. But if you say Ariadne, that dog will look, and the eyes are open. And if I say Ariadne, come in here, I generally just say dog. But Ariadne, come in here, that dog knows it's to come to me, right? If it wanders down the road on the little hill, I may say, Ariadne, get yourself up here. And it will turn around and come up to me. Why? It knows my voice. Knows my voice. See, we are in a situation today that we do not know the voice of God. We think we do. We do. But if it doesn't line up with the word of God, you're hearing the wrong voices. Can I hear somebody say amen? John 14 says, Jesus is talking to the disciples. And I want to pray the Father that he give you another comforter. Notice that, another comforter. Why? Because he's been the comforter to them up to then. I'm going to pray the Father he give you another comforter, that he may abide with you for tomorrow, for the next day, forever. John 14, 26. But the comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, that's what he said, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things. Now, wait a second. Hang on. Did I read that right? But the comforter, anybody else got their Bibles? Just reading. But the comforter, John 14, 26, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my, he shall teach you all things. We sometimes get the Holy Ghost confused with teaching today. If you were to come around into Madisonville, Kentucky, and you were to ask some innocent bystander what the Holy Ghost is, 50% would say tongues. You got into the Pentecostal people, they'd say tongues. Would they not? Yeah. The Holy Spirit's going to teach you all things. He's going to teach you how to walk, teach you how to talk. He's going to teach you how to act. He's going to teach you how to act under trouble. He's going to teach you how to act when persecution hits you. He's going to be your strength. The Bible said, you shall receive power after the Holy Ghost. And then the next line says, and you will be a witness unto me until, the whole world. We get it confused sometimes. We think that it's all about the power, and there is power in the Holy Ghost. But the power that Christ is talking about includes representing Jesus Christ, him crucified and raised from the dead. And if somebody, unfortunately, was to try to kill you, that somehow you get strength and you survive and say, kill me. Is it easy? No. Josephus, the historian, the Jewish historian, said it beautifully. Said that they were writing to Caesar trying to worry about, figure out what to do with the Christians. You read it for yourself in Josephus. He says they would come in and say, you got to go offer sacrifices or we're going to kill you. Said, only 10% said, kill me. And the writer said to Caesar, says, Caesar, this time I bring a centurion soldier over and take a sword to the throat of the individual that has said they won't offer sacrifice. And 10% of that says, okay, I'll go offer sacrifice, meaning 1% did not deny Christ when the opportunity death meant. 1%. We would think we would have the character, and God helped me, I want the character. I'd like to think I do. And if I'm tested, I want you to be able to say, Steve Terry said, go for it. Be strong. Is it easy? Evidently, 99 said it was. 99% said it wasn't. John 16, nevertheless, I tell you the truth. It is expedient for you that I go away, for if I go not away, the Comforter will not come unto you. But if I go, I will send him unto you. Now, let's talk about what it will do for you. I have seen people that received the Holy Spirit and they were able to do wonderful miracles for God. I believe in miracles. I myself am a miracle. I was healed of spinal meningitis. Nobody can take that away from me. Nobody can take that away from me. It was a miracle of God. Not medical science. They was getting ready to do something for me, and it was a miracle of God, instantaneous miracle of God, that I was healed of spinal meningitis. Okay, but are you aware that the Holy Spirit is far greater than miracles? Let's look at the fruit of the Spirit. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, and faith. When an individual gets the Holy Spirit, they that were bad and mean and ugly suddenly are nice and wonderful. Those that had no patience suddenly have patience. Those that had no ability to communicate with the lost, they suddenly have the ability to communicate with the lost. Those that didn't know what peace were, suddenly they have the peace that passes all understanding. Let me tell you something, 1 Corinthians chapter 12, and I said this last Wednesday night, but I believe it bears again. Chapter 12, verse 27. Now ye are the body of Christ, and members in particularly. I can't sing like Barry Potter. I can't play a drum and sing like Big Al or David or Jason, Bobby. I can't even sing as good as Ron, right? So I have to know what I can do. It is not singing to the congregation, is it? Come on now. I have to know what I can do. So let's grab a hold of this. Now you are the body of Christ and members in particular, and God hath set some in the church. First, apostles. What's an apostle? I grew up, a lot of us understand, I remember the days that if you were something for God, you were an evangelist, you know. Then it was revivalist. And then it became, oh, my brother, I am a disciple. Then it was prophet. Prophet was a big term. Oh, he's a prophet of God. Apostle. Now the term is apostle. Apostle supposedly incorporates all of those areas, the teaching, the everything. Okay, but he says here, he's trying to teach the people at Corinth. For if God set in the church first apostles, secondarily prophets, thirdly, here's the pecking order. Thirdly, teachers. Hold on. After that, miracle workers? Wait a second. Surely the Bible, surely Paul had this incorrect. Surely Paul had this incorrect. God has sent to the church first apostles, secondary prophets, thirdly teachers. After that, miracles. Then the gifts of healing. Helps. What's the helps? That's the people that work in the fellowship hall. That's the people that bakes a cake for those in need. That's the people that send cards. That's the people that do the things behind the scene and vacuuming and wiping down the wall. And a big thanks goes out to Teen Challenge ladies. Yesterday, who was it? 2 days ago, Troy? 2 days ago, 8 or 10 of them was down here wiping the walls and sanitizing this entire building from the top of it to the very bottom of it. The chandeliers, they were working for God. Big handout for them. Thank you for your efforts, ladies. Helps governments. And you know what the last thing was? Yeah, hang on. Diversity of tongues. The last thing. Is tongues important? Yeah, Paul said, I speak more tongues than everybody. That's the spiritual side. That's the crying out that you don't even understand. That's the crying out that the spirit inside of you says, he doesn't know how to pray, but I can pray to the Father because I can discuss it one-on-one with the Father. We don't understand all the mysteries of God. We don't. I'm going to read it to you, Acts 2, and then I'm going to be closing. And when the day of Pentecost was fully come, remember what they were doing. They were going to Jerusalem. Now grab a hold of this and pay attention closely to it. Jesus told them to go back to Jerusalem and wait for the comforter. They don't have any idea. He didn't, as far as the word goes, he didn't tell them anything. Now we start off with several hundred, but we only got just a few, 120. Where's the others? I heard somebody say they couldn't all get in the room. So that's okay. And when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all in one accord. We're not talking about a Honda. That's a trivia pursuit question. Never mind. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting. And there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as a fire, and it sat upon each of them. And they were, here we go, all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. And there were dwelling at Jerusalem Jews, devout men, out of every nation under heaven. And when they heard there was noise abroad, the multitude came together, and they were confounded, because that every man heard them speak in their own language. Now, you really got to hang on. And they were amazed and marveled, saying one to another, behold, are not all of these which speak Galileans? And how we hear every man in our own tongue wherein we were born? Parthians, then the Medes, Elamites, and the dwellers of Mesopotamia and Judea, Cappadocia, in Pontus and Asia, Phrygia, Pamphylia, in Egypt, in the parts of Libya and Cyrene, strangers of Rome and Jews and proselytes, Cretes and Arabians, we do hear them speak in our tongues the wonderful works of God. And they were all amazed. That is how the Holy Spirit works. It edifies Jesus Christ and God. If it's doing anything else, be careful. It will never even brag on the Holy Spirit, because it's only there to talk about the wondrous works of God. Wondrous works of God. Today, we have Satan doing many things to deceive. I was in you've seen it. I was in a cake, circle place, where you put your Winnebagos and stuff, something, and you park there overnight or a month or wherever it was. Can't even remember what it's called. What?
RV
Park, thank you. And there this guy came in, and we were in Orlando, and he was trying to find out how to go to Disney. He was from Montreal, Quebec. He could not speak one word of English. And we were trying to, he had a little brochure, and he was, Disney. And he's trying to show the map. And suddenly one of our buddies came over, and his name was Frenchie. And suddenly Frenchie began to speak to him in his native tongue. And that guy smiled and began to speak back in their native tongue. And Frenchie showed this man how to get to Disney. And we, being Hibbily Hicks in Orlando, we were amazed. We were amazed that Frenchie could speak impeccable French. He was from Montreal, Quebec. And Frenchie looked at us and said, "Why are you amazed? That is my native language. Get a hold of what I'm fixing to tell you. The Holy Spirit should be your native language. It should be able to talk to you and you to it, and it should be able to witness to you and you to it, and that it tells you, you have the integrity to obey."
Amen.
You have the integrity to obey. Too often we know what we're supposed to do, but we just, "Lord, use somebody else. Use Jason to do that. Huh? Use Troy to do that." Troy was telling me about the time Pastor told him to do something because the pastor didn't want to do it. Troy said, "I didn't want to do that." I've been there, done that. The pastor gave me and said, "No." I've actually had the courage to tell the pastor, "I ain't doing it." "Did God lay it on your heart?" "Well, yeah." I said, "Then you do it, because God hasn't laid it on my heart." "Steve, are you?" "Yeah, yeah." The Holy Spirit should be able to talk to you. Satan tries to deceive us in many ways. In closing, he tries to whisper in our ears and act like he's God. How many of you ever had that happen? I know some of you, and I forget there's not everybody here, but we think we hear God's voice, and and it wasn't. God was nowhere within 10 miles of that. I'll be truthful with you. I've had it happen to me. I thought for sure God was speaking to me, but Satan was disguising his voice. And I was not mature enough to know that it was Satan. There's a high-stakes poker game in the Middle East. High stakes. Any shepherd that thinks they can do it, they bring all their sheep. Okay? And everyone, they draw lots, and everyone calls their sheep by the voice. They have different kinds. "Hey, hey, hey, oh, oh." And the sheep know to come when that shepherd, and here's how the game works. Each shepherd that has put their sheep in, they get a chance to imitate every other shepherd. And when they all have gone through, what sheep goes to them is theirs. Satan will do his best to imitate Jesus Christ. And if you do not know him personally and have a relationship in the Holy Spirit, guess what? You'll be taken in. That's why he says, my sheep know my voice. I want you to be filled with the Holy Spirit today. I want you to be able to lay hands upon the sick and they recover. I want the discernment of spirit take you and tell you that individual needs prayer. I don't want God to speak to you and you have the integrity to obey his voice. Integrity to obey his voice. See, Satan wants to imitate God, but he can never duplicate him.
Amen.
He can imitate it, but he can't. And if you are a Christian today, full of the Holy Spirit of God, you'll recognize the imitation, because he can never duplicate it. Let's pray. Father, I thank you that you have the ability that you've given us to receive the Holy Spirit. Oh Lord, that not just the Holy Spirit, but that would give us not just the comfort, but the strength that when Satan would come against us in any form, in any situation, that we realize it's the enemy. In the name of Jesus, that was strength, integrity, oh God, to obey your voice. In the name of Jesus, to listen for your calling and obey it. And God, when we mess up, as I have done, in the name of Jesus, that you would strengthen us, remind us that we need to draw closer to you so we understand your voice more clearly. And don't let us be lambs forever. In Jesus' name I pray, and I think the team is going to end us with a song, and that you're blessed today, and hope to see you. There will be no service this Wednesday night. We are looking at a week from Wednesday starting up. When we do start up, we will have a bus available to those that would like to be picked up. Jim and Donna Williams will be glad to pick anybody up. But this particular Wednesday night, we'll not have any service. Next Sunday, we're not going to have any service other than what we're doing here. And we're going to look at June and start off, maybe look at the first week in June is starting off service. But when we start off, we're going to go to church. Amen. So at this time, one more song from the team.
Just like a ship that's tossed and driven.